What prompted you to be a sponsor of the Young Entrepreneurs Initiative?
What prompted me to be a sponsor? I'll tell you what. You know, when I was your age, which was last year, I think. You know, I graduated from high school here in Delhi, and I had to go to America, right? Because I was studying here at St. Stephen's College for a couple of months, and I was studying economics. And I realized, you know, that there was nothing that was a broad-based education, sort of liberal arts, you know. And I think Ashish and I, when we started talking about this, we both realized that it would be criminal if all of you kids would have to go, you know, leave the country to find a broad liberal arts education. So that's why I became the sponsor.
So, do you think this liberal arts education is going to take the education sector of India to the next level?
Yeah, I think so. I think you guys, you know, the thing you guys are, I can already see, you know, even the difference when I first met you guys and now, you know, you guys are very, you know, brilliant even then. But there are many professions in this world. In fact, I would say most of the professions worth doing, they don't teach you that stuff. And, you know, if not, you know, I'm sure a lot of your engineers, a lot of the people in this thing are you know, have been trained for engineering. But engineering is not a profession that's that exciting, to be honest. All the exciting stuff that you guys want to do is all interdisciplinary, is all cuts across disciplines. So you'll hopefully be better prepared for all of that.
And talking about the deregulation of Indian education system, do you think that the universities, foreign universities which come to India, they'll be able to deliver the same standards of education in this country as they do in their home country?
Yeah, why not? I mean, I hope so. I mean, look, I think that, you know, partly it's also, I think, very important to put people from different disciplines together, students. You learn from each other as well, right? And I think partly the talent of the great universities in the world is, of course, the professors, but partly the talent is getting the brightest students to come together. They all learn from each other, right? So we have that here, hopefully. It doesn't matter. I think you guys learn more from each other, I would say, almost, than you learn from your professors, right?
One question related to your profession. What is the difference between investing in the Indian market as compared to the US market?
A lot of differences. I think obviously India is going through a very high growth phase, you know, and so growth investing is what Indian investing is about at the moment. Global investing at the moment is, you know, less about growth, more about value. So I think entrepreneurship is still greatly rewarded in this country. I would encourage a lot of you to go out and think about building businesses after you do this. So I think we're all looking for good entrepreneurs. Hopefully you guys can be some of those.
We'll not disappoint you.
Mm-hmm. One last question, sir. Your profile is extremely inspiring to a lot of fellows here, and so we would like to hear a message from you to the fellows.
I guess what I would say to all of you guys is, you know, don't stop reading in life. Reading is the most important thing. I think people that stop reading stop growing. I think I see a lot of people in my age bracket, you know, younger, older, that have just stopped reading. So I would tell you, one thing I'll tell you guys, you know, take the inspiration you have from here, take and don't lose it. Don't lose the reading habit. Don't lose the habit of learning. You stop learning, you're going to stop growing. So that's my...
I take the liberty of asking you one last question before...